In this video, I am going to show you how to use the Xamarin iOS framework to create an iPhone application with a list. And so we often want to make lists that either take up the whole space of a view or not, but we have data to display. And sometimes that data is obviously like a list of rows, but other times it's not always recognizable that we're doing things like editing in the Contacts app or the list of conversations in the Messages app. But we often have this need in our applications to display items in kind of that list row format. And so the table control, table view control in the iOS Xamarin tools is typically the best way to do this. And if you've done any Android development, or if you're working alongside with my Android Xamarin videos, the table view control, or UI table view control, is the most similar to the list view class in Android. Very similar framework, very similar adapter. So we're going to start and set up our iPhone application as a single view app. And what we're going to build is an application that displays a list of items that the user can then click on. And when they click on one of those items in the list, we are going to look at how to launch the browser window so that Safari will open and do a search for that particular item in Google. So once you have your project set up, come on over to your, let's first check our Mac agent, make sure that we're connected. Looks like mine not connected, so it's pending that connection, and I probably need to log into my Mac, which is probably gone to sleep. So once you have that connected, go over to your Solution Explorer and get your UI open so that we can get started with adding our control. So once you're into your UI, come over here to your toolbox, and under the Data Views section, find your table view. So we're going to grab one of those and place it onto our view. And over in the properties, and you can, you know, move it around if you don't like where it's sitting. You know, we could make it a little bigger. That way we get all of our list items filling the space. And I'm going to give it the name table data. And that's all we're going to do to the UI. So let's go ahead and get rid of these windows and come over to our Solution Explorer and open up our view controller so we can get started on our code. So we really only need two lines of code over here in the view did load section, because the magic really doesn't happen here in the view controller. We are going to have to set up our table source so that our table view knows where to get its data from. So this is basically a custom class. So I'm going to come over here to my Solution Explorer, right-click my project, go to Add a Class, and I'm going to name it Table Source, so I remember what it's for. Really no naming convention here. And it is going to inherit from the UI Table View Source, and that's not going to come up without the using statement. We need the UI kit, and we also need foundation. So this table source class ultimately inherits from this UI table view source, and table view source contains all of the properties and methods that we need to work with in order to make our table view behave the way that we want it to. The downside of having to do it this way is there are more things that we must override in table source than we're going to use in this tutorial. And so I'm going to start with the basics, right? Let's set up a couple of strings. So I'm just going to create we'll make it a protected array, string array, to hold our table items. And I'm also going to need, tripping over my hands today, a protected string, and we're going to call it cell identifier. Pre-initialize that. And then we're also going to need an instance of our view controller, and I like to call this owner. You'll find a lot of tutorials like to call this owner. It just seems to make sense in your mind when you think about where is the originator of this information in this view. So we're going to set up a constructor for our table source class. And this constructor is going to take in, and we're working with just a string of, an array of strings. But if you wanted to, you know, bind your table view to something else, you could definitely do that. Oops. That should be item. Should really be items. Really dislike it when arrays aren't plural. Okay, so after our constructor, we are going to override the rows in section property, method. And the rows in section is called by table view to determine how many cells to create in that particular section. And if you really dig into the UI part of customizing your table view, you'll see that you can also group and do other things to your tables. And so this also helps with that. So we'll have public override. This is an init. Whoops. Rows in section. And all this needs to return is the table items length. So it knows how many cells to create. Now the magic happens in row selected. Row selected is what we will override. And you can also see there's row deselected if you wanted to have things happen, as well as like what happens when I highlight a row. Or you can even set up for what happens if you move a row, because you can set up some touch functionality for your table views. It's actually quite a robust little thing. But row selected, this is the magic. So what do we want to have happen when the row is selected? Well, first I was going to show you how to add in UI alerts. So similar to Android Toast functionality, if you're familiar with that, we just want a visual UI pop-up to confirm our selection. But remember, we're also going to open the browser window, and we want to be able to navigate and do a Google search for whichever item was selected. So we're going to start with the Toast notification kind of thing first, right? These are called UI alerts. And so we have a UI alert controller. Name it whatever you want to name it. And so this is a UI alert controller. We're going to do a create. And I'm just going to say row selected. And then in here, what do we want to put? Well, we want table items. Oops, not in the string. We want table items, and we want the index path dot row. So that's what we're going to display. And then you have to indicate a style. So this is a UI alert controller style. It's an alert. So once you have that set up, then you can add that, you can set up the action that you want it to perform. So we're going to add an action. So this is a UI alert action. We'll create that. And it's just going to give us kind of an OK button, because you can set up, you know, what kind of action do you want. And then style, we'll just use the default style. We don't need a third parameter. This should be a dot create. That's why it's yelling. Okay, then finally we can present it. And so owner is our view controller. We will present We need the presented present. I need the present. Present. I'm not spelling it right. There we go. The present view controller. So we add our alert controller. Do we want to animate it? Yeah, we do. Do I need a completion handler? No, I don't. And that's it. That will pop up a cute little notification that just says row selected, whatever item name it is, and then an OK button. And if you want to go ahead and run and test, we haven't set up our list yet, so you won't be able to see this, but just a second, and we're going to check it out anyway. So how do I open the browser window and do this search that I want to do? Well, we do what's called a shared application. So in the UI application class, we can do a shared application. And so every app that's installed on your iOS device is kind of registered for all the different types of things it can do. So if I say I want to open a URL, then whatever app is specified as I'm the thing that opens URLs is going to open. So we don't need to specify and say, hey, I specifically need Safari to do this thing. Right? That's not really how it works. So open URL is just going to automatically appoint which app to do which thing. So we just set up where we want it to go. So this is a new NS URL, and then in the parentheses, in the quotes, we put what we want to have happen, like what's our URL. Well, the URL, I just went to Google and did a Google search, and I searched for hats so that I could see what that string looked like. And so this is what I got. But I don't want hats to be hard-coded in there. I want to concatenate on this, basically, because this is the word in the list that I want to search for. So we'll do a Google search, and into that query string right here, if that's a familiar term, then we'll query for whatever item in the table they selected. So we can do a Google search for hats if it's in the list. The last thing that we need to do is just go ahead and set up what happens when they deselect the row. It's just kind of an ending action. And so I'm just going to give it the index path true. So that just all we're really saying here is when they click off the row, right, when they've deselected the given row in the table view, do we want to animate the deselection? And do what do we want to do? Well, yeah, I just want to animate it. I don't want to do anything else, just show the cute little UI animation. Now, this won't build right now because we're still missing an implementation of getCell. Now, we're not doing anything with getCell, and I just wrote it out over here, and I'm going to paste it in here so that you can see what it looks like. But getCell is called by the table view to get the actual UI table view cell and render it for that particular row. So it has to be implemented when we override the class. But in this case, we aren't doing anything with it. And so you're free to just go ahead and copy this, and I'll just leave it there for a second. And you could pause the video, and now we're ready to move on. So the last little bit of magic is setting up the string of items that we want to ultimately supply to our table data source. So I'm just going to set up a string array. And like I said, you could supply it with something different if you wanted. And we're just going to search for like clothing items. So like shirts, pants, put in here whatever you want, shoes, apples, tortillas. Do you know how to spell tortillas? Okay. As many of them in there as you want. Now we just supply this array to our table data source. So I have my table data class dot source is a new table source. And so I have my items array. And then who's the owner? This is the owner. This view controller right here is the owner. So go ahead and give that a build. Make sure that builds and that everything's clean, because we should be ready to test. Right? That is pretty much the end. We have built our table source class that overrides the properties we needed it to override and the methods we needed it to override, so that we can load up a table view in our UI and display a list of items. And then when they click on that list of items, we will display a little UI notification, and then the browser will open and do our search. So let's look at the app. Let's get this loaded in my simulator because it was a clean build. And we can look at this and see, does it work? Okay, so my app has loaded over here in my emulator. And we can see here's our list. I'm trying not to bounce the camera too much, guys. I'm sorry. And so here's my list of items. So when I click on one, I get that nice little UI thing. And if you missed it, I'll do it again. I can pull the camera back so you can see better. And then we did our Google search. There we go. Shoes. Excellent. And there you go. There is our little UI alert. There's our row selected that we put in there. Shoes was the item we selected. So it's, remember, it's pulling it out through that index path selection. And then we set up that OK button. So when we click OK, it just goes away. And now I can click on shirts. And we did a Google search for shirts. We did really awesome. Yay. We go back. And there's our UI notification. And so now you know how to create an iOS app using the Xamarin tools that uses a table view control. And you've looked at how to set up UI alerts as well as open the browser using a shared application call. So I hope you've enjoyed making another little iOS application with me. And check out